My name is Erik Hall. I'm an adjunct instructor in the Sociology Department in the Forensic Science Program. In addition to working here at St. Louis University, I also work in the St. Louis Police Department in the Crime Lab. So I'm a DNA analyst at that Crime Lab. I pretty much analyze evidence for body fluids, and then run them through the DNA process and see if we could obtain any DNA results off of those. JonBenét Ramsey is one of those high-profile cases that really has potentially piqued interest in forensic science. Back when it happened, I believe it was 1996, a lot of the DNA technology was just up and coming. They're still developing the DNA techniques that we're using today. So in 1996, the technology just wasn't as powerful as it was today. What that allowed those investigators to do is maybe relook at the case. We'll go back and reanalyze the samples that they looked at the first time. Can they gain more information? Can they develop profiles off something that they couldn't develop them off of back in 1996? The initial crime scene, it needs to be preserved. And with JonBenét Ramsey, the first thing, from my understanding, is the family called over a bunch of friends. I think a pastor came over. A whole bunch of people were in that house before the investigators even realized that maybe this is a crime scene. And I think that's the difference between 1996 and 2016. In 2016, as soon as we think there's any indication that there might be a crime, it's locked down. Nobody's in or out. It's locked down until the detectives and the crime scene investigators get there to begin their processing. I think you could see it in the O.J. Simpson case as well. Same issues. You know, back in the 90s, there was a lot of crime scene issues. How do you properly preserve a crime scene? How do you protect it? Who do you let in? Who don't you let in? So all these things played into potentially that case as well. Did evidence get planted? Did evidence go missing? They're all theories, but theories could impact juries. Theories could impact cases. Theories get evidence potentially thrown out in court. Whether they're true or not, it doesn't matter. It's up to the crime scene investigators. It's up to those initial detectives to lock down that crime scene and allow it to be processed without contamination, without people introducing or removing stuff from the scene without it being documented. So I think in both those cases, you could see this common thread of potential contamination.